Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to create a valve body in SOLIDWORKS, and here we will learn some basic commands or features, and you will see how to make this one. This is a simple tutorial, good for the beginners, and we will see how to make threads and cosmetic thread. So now here let's try to create valve body, and we will learn some basic tools. File, new, select your part. Background, you can change it from here. Now this is your valve body design. So see here, outer radius here shows radius, that means diameter 60 millimeter, and the length of the body 87 millimeters. So first we will extrude this one, then we will cut this bottom shape. See 11.5 millimeter, and the here radius 5 millimeter, and here inside edge you will see 24.25. so I'll show you how. And this one is R46 outer radius. So these things we are going to use cut with the help of revolve cut command. So now let me choose front plane, sketch, circle, and here first step is 60 millimeter, enter. Now see, if you like to keep this one as a radius, simply choose this one, go to ladder, and here you will find option radius. Now see, it is 30 millimeter. Extruded boss base, and 87 millimeter is the length, but here we will keep this one in mid plane so that it will moves in both side and we will get a perfect center point. Let me uncheck now. Okay, now we will choose right plane, sketch, normal, center line. Now let me try from here, go back to the point, and you will get we want to make a reverse arc, so we will choose 3-point arc. Let's choose mirror. Oh, we need a center line for mirror. Now let me choose mirror, and here select these two things, mirror about, let me choose this one. Okay, again I'll select here 3-point arc, connect this one. Okay, now select the arc and hold shift key, and this point make relation tangent, actually it should be tangent, or select the outer edge. It's difficult to choose, but possible. Okay, let me do one thing, let's make first tangent. .5 millimeter, and this distance we saw in drawing 24.5 millimeter. Okay, now here radius shown 5 millimeter. Okay, now let's do one thing, coincide. Let's close this body. And for defining purpose, define any dimension so that our geometry will be fully defined. Now here we forget to add the dimensions, this radius 46 millimeter. Now see, this is fully defined. So it's time to use revolve cut command and create our body. So choose revolve cut, and here in axis of revolution choose this one. If we check preview, Now see, even though let's try to use some steel, polished steel. Okay, now let's try to cut inside. No, we will extrude this upper body. See here, the upper body is ...50 millimeter. We forget to mention here, this distance is 50 millimeter, and down to up to the body, but this distance 38 millimeter. Oh. First we will create a plane, choose plane, first option we will choose top plane, and distance 38 millimeter upper side. Okay, select the plane, sketch, and here draw 50 millimeter, enter, and go to feature and select extruded boss base, make it reverse and select here up to next. Now see, it's going to attach with this. Hide. Now we are going to cut from the inside, and from the inside you will see this gap is 36. If you calculate half is 54 millimeter, the wall thickness. So let's try to cut this one. So again we will choose the same right plane, sketch, normal. Now let's try to select outer edge. Once you select outer edge, convert entity, once you select outer edge, select offset entity, 4 number reverse. Now let me choose this side and this side. Okay, that's it. I'll draw one center line, and I'll draw a line up to here and connect with this. Let's hold this one, select this line and make full line, this line also make full line. Now this one we will define. ...18 millimeter. ...18 millimeter. Now see, everything is defined. Only we need to trim unnecessary lines, power trim, and trim this one. Okay, even though select the line, uncheck geometry pattern, and this is going to be trimmed, going to cut. Select your axis of revolution, choose this vertical line. You will see the preview. See, it's going to cut. If we saw section view, see, uncheck. Now it's time to cut and extrude this one. The first circle is 52, and we will extrude this one up to 10 millimeter, and then there is one hole, and this hole is 42.5 millimeter. So we will make this two first. Select top face, sketch, here we will make two circles, 52, enter, 42.5, enter. Let's try to choose extruded boss base, and here we will select first outer circle only. See, you will get a solid body, not circle ring. 10 millimeter and keep blind and select bottom direction. See, we will get a step. Again, we will use the same sketch, but this time we will choose extruded cut. And in selected contour, choose this center. And here select up to next. Once you select next, it will see, show you, it will cut up to the end of thickness wall. Oh, look. Now see. So the main body is created. Let's see what else inside. Okay. Now we will try to cut this body. So this body is 4 millimeter, and this is parallel to this body. So 17.5 millimeter, this is the distance from here to here. 4 millimeter thickness, 30 millimeter corner radius, 3 millimeter this thickness also, for here 24 millimeter is hole, center hole. So let's make this one 2 millimeter, the center distance. Now let's do one thing, choose fillet. Now here I'll choose this view so that we will get a perfect shape. See here, if you choose section view, it will give you better look, but we don't need this one. Let me draw one vertical line. Make sure this is start from this corner point, and the same line we will drive from this corner. Actually, this is the reference line. Center line. Okay. So let's start our geometry. We will start from this point. And try to cover more than this line and up to this line. Make sure it is vertical line and connect. Don't go beyond the body, but make sure your line will be below this line so that you will get a perfect body. Four millimeter. This gap 7 millimeter, and the center distance from here to bottom line 2 millimeter. Okay, and let's make this 2 distance also 4 millimeter. We need to define this body, so allocate any dimensions from here, but make sure this is above this construction line. Okay, here one more things, we need to make this one in center, so select center point and origin point. Now select the line vertical, so it is comes in center. Now choose this line, create relation collinear. See, it is comes in one line. See, our geometry is fully defined. If you shaded with edge, this is the, now it's time to extrude. So how you will do extruded boss base? Now here we need to choose up to body. See, we will choose this body, and in direction 2 also choose up to body and choose this body. See, it's moving both side. I'll show you the preview, just wait. Now look, I'll show you section view. Okay, now see section view, this is the body created. Now let's try to add fillet 3 millimeter, 1 bottom one was not there, so we will remove. So this much is enough, 3 millimeter radius, and here the diameter is 20. Select this face, sketch, circle 24 millimeter, enter. See here, extruded cut, and what command we are going to choose here? Up to next. See, it's going to cut only up to the thickness of wall. Oh, look. If I'm going to uncheck, see, you will see the preview. Okay, now this one finished. Now let's add here one flange, and this here we already added here. Hexagon flange and 56 millimeter the vertical length, and horizontal length 48.5 millimeter and up to 11.5. that's it. We will extrude, add this one, and we will add thread. So we will add cosmetic thread, not real, even though I'll show you how to add real thread. 40 m 45 into 1.5, and here m 39 into 2 pitch 2 millimeter. Select this face, sketch, polygon, 6 number of polygons. I'll select. Now select this line vertical. Okay, now I'll choose the circle, hold shift key and the inside circle, and make relation equal. See, it is fully defined. Select inside circle, convert entity, extrude 11.5 millimeter reverse direction, make sure it is merged. Oh, look, even though we can create in opposite side also in the same way either, but we will try here mirror command, front plane, and here feature to mirror. This one we extruded. Say okay. Oh, see, it's mirror. We forget to add here fillet 1 millimeter. Look, now let's try to add both the fillets, either cosmetics and normal. So first we will add cosmetic. Go to insert, annotation, cosmetic thread. First here we need to select edge, so I'll choose this edge. Once you select edge, it will ask you matrix, we need to create thread, and by default it will automatically choose the things. So here 39 m39 is suitable for this hole, and the length 12 millimeter long. Okay. Now go to option documents property image quality, no detailing, and select here shaded cosmetic thread. Check the box. Okay. Now you will see the threads applied here. In the same way, we can apply the thread here also. We selected the edge. We selected the face also. Blind condition 12 millimeter. See. This is the suitable for this 45 by 1.5, 12 millimeter long. Now let's try to add real thread. So select thread. Now here the same thing, we need to choose edge. So I'll select this edge. Now see, you will see the preview how it's going to start, but length, twelve millimeter, but we need to little make offset. Why? Because we will not get the edge perfect. 3 millimeter, and depth we will keep 15 millimeter. So that we will get a 12 millimeter depth. Select reverse offset. See, it comes little out, so that we will get our geometry perfect shape. 42 into 4.5, this is the we need to use tap so that we will get a depth. Cut thread. I'll just select one by one and I'll show you the preview. Here left hand side thread and here right hand side thread. Now offset from here we will choose 5 millimeter because this is big diameter, comes up, and thread pitch also higher, 42 4.5 45 1.5 sorry. We have only two pitch options, 42 into 3 millimeter. So we will try a smaller one. Cut thread and left, right, whatever you like. Now let me add some. This is look better, but we will add steel, polished steel. Even though if you like, you can click hide this cosmetic thread. Now see, this is, so this is the simple tutorial how we create a valve body in SolidWorks. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.